me because I did Mr. John Abraham's hair. And so, he was a big John Abraham fan because he had that same fucked up, straightened, chutia hair that I hate so much. Yeah, even John! He knows it, John, I love you, baby, but that hair, I'm glad it's gone, yeah? And so, yeah, he said, ye baal kisne kiya, mere ko wahan jana hai. Achha, sir, hum maloom karte hai. So they called, so his manager's sister was really good friends with my friend Shushma Reddy. So Shushi called me up, she said, listen, babe, these guys are going to call you. I said, which guys? Arey, they'll just call you, some cricket stuff is happening. Okay. And that time I got this call. Hello. I was like, yes. We are MS Dhoni's management. Okay. Whatever that means. Because I had no clue about cricket at that point at all. And little did I know, I was entering this magical world of a magic man who's going to change my life. So, bas, yehi hua. MS Dhoni ka call aya. Hum gaye Taj. Taj Kulaba, because that's where the entire team is to hang out. I was like, oh fuck, what am I gonna wear? Okay, I'll wear black. And it was holy day also, and I was like, great, you guys couldn't have found a better day on holy. So I'm in this cab, fully like, don't touch me, you assholes, I'll kill you if you throw color on me. So I get to Taj and I'm waiting downstairs in the lobby, like, okay, ab kya hoga? And here he comes with his manager, and I look at him. And there's silence for 5 minutes because he has never seen a fucking woman who looks like this, and I have not seen mainly orange hair on a handsome fucker like him. And that was it. It was love at first hair sight. Oh my god, he's the nicest human I have ever met, and I don't say that about too many people. And he is so down to earth. It's sick. It's almost sick. And your call time is 9 o'clock. You don't have to come at 8:59, you choot. Come at 9:05. It's okay. Because fuck, that pressure's on me. Like, if I'm late because of Bombay traffic, Mahendra Singh Dhoni is going to be there. And I want to look like the asshole who came later than MSD. Right? He does that to everybody on set. And we're like, oh shit, we better be on time, we're gonna look like that asshole. So yeah. Thanks for making us all look like assholes, but keeping us on our toes, right? Yeah. Maybe you can ask me a question that no one's ever asked me. Have I ever had a crush on MS Dhoni? Ooh. Ooh, that can get sexy.
Can we ask the question now?
Yes.
Tell us. Have you?
Yes. Oh my god, to the point where my boyfriend used to be like, dude, why is MSD calling you? I'm like, I'm his hairdresser. Why does he need to call you? Arey, he needs products, dude. I need to consult on the phone, even though he can't see anything. But it's important. It's to make up the weirdest things why I need to have a conversation with MSD on the phone, even though it's got nothing to do with anything. Now the secret is out, Mahi, but whatever. We're still cool. Sakshi, I love you. You know that. It's all good. Ziva, are baby, I am to there for you, baby.
Who can't have a fucking crush
on MSD, and he's so fucking handsome. And he only gets more and more handsome all the time. And you know what, girls? I'm so lucky because I get to touch him all the time. And you don't. Yeah.
Yeah, that's,
I'm cool.
People are just going to ignore.
Yeah. Hey, but you know, the flip side is he has a good looking fucking stylist as well. Yeah.
Absolutely.
There's not one cricketer out there who has such a good looking stylist. So if I get to touch him, he also gets to get touched by a good looking woman.
Any other cricketer you want to say?
Hey, there is this one guy I think is really cute. He's got lots of potential. I think he's gonna take over. Mr. Manish Pandey. Ooh, baby, he's cute. Potential.